This is a Maverick, and inside its carbon fiber body, this tiny aircraft carries with it cutting-edge technology. Controlled either by remote or through a pre-programmed flight path, it offers operators a bird's-eye view of the ground below and can launch from just about anywhere. Its makers say buyers from across the spectrum are lining up for training sessions.
We say, hey, you can find something, you can look at it, you can track it. And they say, oh, you know what we also can do? We can do this. We can do agriculture. We can do pipeline inspection. So we're getting kind of feedback that the plane is more versatile than we even thought.
And small, highly advanced drones are increasingly being approved by the US government for use in civilian airspace, making this a booming business.
The applications for unmanned aerial vehicles are limitless. These craft are currently being bought by the US military, civil engineers, and the emergency services. But as this technology becomes more advanced and these eyes in the sky more prevalent, there are now concerns about privacy.
For human rights lawyers like Professor Winston Nagin, it's the lack of regulations that worries him the most.
The moral framework, the circumstances, and the restraints. I need to see that as a matter of the public policy of a great power. And I haven't seen that. So needless to say, I am uneasy about it. But I'm not the only one.
But at the facility where the Mavericks are designed and built, there are no concerns about privacy. The company's CEO says drones have been used to fight fires and save lives. Invading people's privacy is the last thing on his mind.
We carry cell phones where we voluntarily input all of our personal information. These things, these tools that exist, much more easily violate our privacy or violate our rights than any unmanned aircraft system.
And while the debate over the use of drones continues to heat up, it's estimated that by 2015, there'll be more than 7,000 of these craft in the skies above North America. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Gainesville, Florida.